Tandem Biking. 3 weeks left. It's not every day that I'm in Africa. Yeah, right now it seems to me that I am in Africa every day since I've been here for over 5 months, but despite that feeling, the truth is that today in Africa is a very exceptional day compared to the rest of my life. So I've been trying to make as many memories as I can, experience as many things, and learn as many lessons as I can in this last stretch. There's a motto that I've tried to adopt. It goes, if you've been given a moment and you can either let it pass or go make a memory, always make the memory. So the other day, I took my camera and went for a long walk in search of things to photograph. I knew my mom would have a fit if she knew how few pictures I've actually taken at this point. As I walked out of town and toward the river, a wrinkly, elderly man came riding up beside me on one of those rickety bikes that I've written about. Lapia, 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 budja! Okay, little guy, calm down, I thought. He stopped his bike to talk, and when he found out that we were going in the same direction, he told me that I could ride on the back of his bike. Wow, like hitchhiking. I would never in my life pass up a chance like that. So I sat on the little metal rack behind his bike seat and swung my legs down in case the takeoff wasn't as smooth as we wished. He tried to get going, but I was definitely bigger than he was. His frail little leg muscles couldn't push us down the sandy path on that dying bicycle. So we decided that I would give it a go and that he would ride in the back. That worked a lot better. The bike got tipsy in a few places, and there were times when I thought for sure we were going to take a tumble. However, we pulled it off. I even managed to take a snapshot of the two of us while riding the bike. We rode a few miles. This was no short jaunt. And I asked him a couple times, should we turn here? Should we stop here? He always hurriedly shrieked his answer. No, not yet. I'll tell you. I'll tell you. I'll give you a warning before the road comes. I think he was worried that if we stopped, we wouldn't get going again. Eventually, we got to the next village, and the little man introduced me to his family and one of his wives, and then they started making plans to feed me. I knew it was getting dark, and I still had to run back the 3 miles. The sun had already set when I finally started jogging. It got darker and darker, and I started passing some interesting types of people. One straggly-looking man was walking in snake patterns, and his eyes hardly focused. Rice wine had gotten him good. I picked up my pace and sent cautious glances over my shoulder from time to time. Soon, a young boy came up beside me on his bike and started talking to me with all the English he knew. Hello, how are you? I am fine. Where are you going? What is your name? He said in one long stream. He sure knew how to get the conversation going. He accompanied me all the way home. Not that I'm afraid of the dark or anything.